All right, thanks, Scott. So we do have, you know, all these great items that we want to hang on to, but we don't really know what to do with, especially heirlooms or antiques from family members. Well, Allison Smith has a great interior design company. You go to companies, you go to people's homes, called Gem and Clay Interiors. Yes. Thanks for being with us today.
Thanks for having me.
So now the big thing, and we just had a segment on this last week, is going through your house. And because of that show, especially tidying up in the first of the year, people are saying, okay, I don't need this stuff, I don't need this stuff, so they're donating it.
Right.
But you want to make sure that one day you don't say, why did I give my grandmother's quilt away, or why did I do, but then at the time we have them packed up in boxes and we're not doing anything with it.
Right.
So you're kind of taking some of that nostalgia and showing us how to showcase it and let it be a part of our everyday and let it bring us joy.
Yes, yeah, if it does bring you joy, then you should keep it. You don't want to throw away items that are connected to good memories.
Sure.
Because it can be good for your wellness, and it's also really the best way to translate your personality through the design of your home. So keep those items, but take them out of the boxes. You're sitting on hidden gems there. So
right.
Use
Get them out
of
the basement.
Yes.
Okay, so what do you have here?
So here I have an antique mirror. And this is actually my great-great-aunt's mirror.
Oh my.
And so to kind of bring it into the today, I paired it with a plant here on the floor, and you want to put the plant in a more modern basket or box to kind of make it look fresh. The idea here is grouping the old items with the newer items to breathe new life into it. Just remember, when you're pairing it with a basket on the floor like that, put a plant saucer underneath the plant.
Oh yes, because you don't want to ruin your floor.
Yeah, you want to catch the water. Right. So this is a good way to kind of pair, if you have a mirror or wall art or something, put a plant in a modern basket next to it and it'll look fresh again.
And that's like even the name of your company, about old
yes.
and new.
Yes, it's a representation of old and new.
Gem and clay.
Yes, this is the thing I love to do, is showing people how to do that.
So what do you have? This grouping looks, I love these kind of trays on the end of a bed or on a couch like this. It's beautiful.
This is great in a living room or a bedroom. And if you have an old teacup, plant a plant in it.
That's so
a little
cute.
House
so that's
plant.
What this, oh, is yeah. that sweet.
Now that specifically isn't an actual vintage teacup,
right.
but you get the idea.
Yeah.
And you get double duty. You have the air purifying qualities of the plant. You pair it with some modern magazines, modern coasters, and a modern tray, of course. And then add some height behind it with a candle holder
I love
or something.
That. So grab grandmother's teacup or something. Mm-hmm. I love that.
Yes.
Cute. Okay, so this is really interesting here.
So here we have, if you have an old quilt or an old blanket, this is a handmade blanket. Ladders are really in. And what I like about ladders are you can find a ladder to match your decor style. Mm. So if your style is farmhouse or super clean and modern or industrial, there's a ladder to match it.
Sure.
They sell ladders everywhere. And so another way to make it look fresh is not only a modern ladder, but a modern blanket along with it. So kind of add that as a nice little backdrop to your blanket and you can keep it on display.
Love it. Okay.
Now here I have vintage perfume bottles. So these are my grandmother's perfumes, actually. And you can find something like this at any craft store. Mm-hmm. And so the idea is pairing some prettier bottles with sculptural detail with a more rustic, and you're getting the contrast of the rustic, and then obviously adding something green always freshens it up. And also this clean lined box kind of balances it and makes it look not so busy.
Are you, and that's a key word, I think, with you saying making it look not so busy. Do you have other stuff back there? Let's move over here.
And right here, this is just to touch on this real quick, any antique piece looks modern with some modern books.
Now, so this is our producer, Margaret Dakin's,
yes.
I think grandfather's coal mine lamp. Isn't
that
precious?
Yeah, and so the idea is just making a little platform with a couple books, and it makes
so
it look fresh.
These letters are beautiful. Thank you for bringing those in and showing us this.
Now, everyone has old photos, old letters, recipes, what have you, and you make it fresh by putting them in some modern frames, And this makes it cohesive, having the white mat in each frame. So it kind of brings it all together. You can put it on a table like this or on a wall.
I love the picture that we're looking at too, with the perfume bottles and all those pictures. And then I brought in, because these were so important to me, my mother's apple crisp recipe. And these were actually, Albee Designs did these, and my grandmother's banana cake recipe. So I have these hanging on the wall.
That
Instead of keeping
them
in a little recipe book, she did it exactly in their handwriting. Maybe a little misspelling that my grandmother did that makes me like just miss her so much.
Wow.
It's so sweet. So these are things that I look at every single day, and it warms my heart. But I love having those things still in your life and not just packed away in boxes.
Right.
Thank you for being with us.
Thanks
so
for
people can
me.
Find out more about you and your company on Fox8.com. We are going to take a short break. Much more coming your way. Stay close.